of two passenger jets in the space of just a few months as Malaysia's flag carrier has. Even before those calamities, the company was in deep trouble, having lost $350 million last year. But the twin blows of MH370 and MH17 have driven it much deeper into the red. For the quarter from April to June, Malaysia Airlines lost close to $100 million, bringing the total losses for the first half of the year to $230 million.
We haven't even added the factor of MH17, which will only show itself in the third quarter. It just re-emphasizes the point that the restructuring has to happen now. Not a day of delay can be accepted. And, you know, they're just fighting against time to survive.
The state investment arm, Khazanah, is planning to buy up the 30% of stock it doesn't yet own to delist Malaysia Airlines from the stock exchange and do a drastic restructuring. Khazanah submitted its restructuring plan for cabinet approval on Wednesday and could unveil it publicly as early as Friday. It's expected to suggest closing unprofitable routes, relooking at all existing contracts and cutting Malaysia Airlines' 19,000-strong workforce by as much as one-third. In the past, the airline's influential unions have fought efforts to trim the workforce to reduce costs. Now they appear to realise that may be unavoidable.
I think the union will give its support. However, we must study the grave measures that's going to be undertaken. We're open, but we also have got to look at the interests of the workers too, because we don't want to have people who have served the airline long or who have a future in this airline business to lose their jobs. It's going to create more problems than good.
Thursday's financial results suggest the situation is so grave that deep cuts may be the only way to save Malaysia's ailing national airline. Ryan Meltzer, CCTV, Kuala Lumpur.